back to the channel. It's myself, Dave, joined by none other than Ryan McGinley on the right-hand side. It's nice to have someone else on the channel for a little bit of discussion. Ryan, it's Wednesday morning now, but Wednesday afternoon now. How are you doing, mate?
Yeah, not too bad, mate. Another day closer to the fans being back in the stadiums, which is absolutely brilliant. I'm just counting down the days now till we can get back.
I know, I think that's a really good point to start off the video. I never made a video yesterday. I was kind of toying with the idea of making a sort of live stream or a video to do with the return of fans, but I'm fed up of talking about the limbo between them, us being there and not being there, so I just couldn't be bothered, because knowing our luck, we'll get stripped away from the stadiums again at some point this year. But yeah, we're back in. We're going to be there Monday night, full capacity for the Hibs game as we return to SPFL fixtures. Not only is it the return of fans, it's just the return of football in general, Ryan. It's been a kind of empty 3 weeks without it. We're going to have a podcast before it probably to talk about it in depth. But I mean, hearing that yesterday was sort of kind of the icing on the cake to football coming back.
Yeah, I've got to be honest. I was quite confident that that would be the case, just the way cases were going and the way the cases were going down and such. I've totally forgot what I was going to say. Yeah, but everything was pure positive. And then obviously we heard the news that the fans were coming back. I was worried that they might do like a phased return, like it was only going to be like about 20,000. But thankfully that wasn't the case, and we're all getting back in for a really big game against Hibs as well. It's not as if it's a pure rubbish game to come back to. Hibs under a new manager. They'll have new signings. We might have players that played for us last month coming up against us. So it's very, very exciting. I'm looking forward to it. A game against Hibs is always a good game, and it's a quarter to eight kickoff, I'm sure. So that's a pretty good time to be going to the game.
Monday night football, it's a rarity in Scotland, so I'm looking forward to it. But one of the things that I wanted to touch on before we talk about the main topic in today's video is I kind of told you so sort of thing, because I made a video when the fans were taken away from the grounds, and there was a lot of Rangers fans in my comments section giving it the whole, oh, well, you're daft. You're sitting there defending it. You're daft if you think that you want the winter break. You're daft. You think we'll be back come the end of it. Well, here we are, end of the winter break. Fans are back. And the move that 10 out of 12 Premiership clubs wanted turned out to be the right move, McGinley. It didn't happen to be for any other reason other than, you know, the facts and the numbers that were there to show that maybe it would have worked if we moved it forward.
Not so bad for the 10 teams that shat it, know what I mean? Nah. That was good of them to give it 3 weeks, see what the situation was like. I mean, that was that. We wanted to give them the best possible chance of getting fans back in, because the game without supporters is just not the same game. Yeah. I might sound like a Celtic dad saying that, but it really isn't.
No, you're right.
We got a wee taster of that against St Johnstone, and it was awful. The 90 minutes were absolutely awful to watch. There was only 500 fans there, and it was a bit of a chore, especially the second half. So it's so good that the fans will be back. And do you know what? It wasn't even due to the fact that we were getting players in or we had players injured. It was all due to the fans. That was the consistency the whole way through. It was all about getting fans back. We would have played those games if we had to, but the good thing is 9 other teams agreed with us, and it looks as if it paid off.
Aha, came across on my Twitter not long before we sat down to make this video. A Rangers fan shared a video of Jermaine Defoe scoring against Celtic last season in one of the games where Rangers obviously dismantled us. But, I mean, it was one of those games. And they shared a video of Defoe and some sort of caption about how Defoe's a great player or whatever. You know, that's nothing to do with the point I'm going to make. But you know, I was watching it. I clicked on it just because I forgot what the goal was. And I clicked on it and watched it. And I thought to myself, why on earth would they want this again? The stadium being empty, Defoe celebrating to an empty stand, nothing but the cheer of the touchline. It was horrendous. Mm-hmm. And I mean, I know there was a celebration for Rangers fans because, of course, last season was last season for them. But my God almighty, if you want empty grounds, have a hard look at yourself, because it's unbelievable. And I'm glad that we are back on Monday. And not only us going to be back on Monday, Celtic will be back, along with their new signings, Ryan, the guys that we had the chance to speak to yesterday. Well, you had the chance to speak to yesterday at the fan media press conference. Like, before we go in to talk about what we heard yesterday and showing a couple of clips here and there about that fan media press conference, I've seen a lot of sort of negativity surrounding the fan media press conference.
Yeah.
Look, all I want to say is, look, me and Ryan are out with control and how these things are operated. We don't run it. We don't really get to recommend anything. We basically get invited, we turn up, and we do what we're told to do. If it was up to me and if I was in charge, I would probably have it in a different fashion so it was a little more entertaining, but it is what it is. We do appreciate every opportunity we're given to talk to these guys. And I know a lot of people are frustrated at how boring it was, and the fact there was only one question to each player. It is frustrating, but
it wasn't even one question to each player. It was one question to one player.
That's right.
And look, that was a really annoying thing.
It's out with our control. We really don't get the chance to do anything. So Ryan went anyway, and a fantastic job as always, Ryan. You sat up all night preparing your questions for what you thought would have been for every player, but it was only for one, and you chose to speak to the new boy, Rio Hatate. Before we talk about his answer, I'm going to put on a clip in screen now of Ryan's question and Rio's answer. We'll also have a section of the press conference at the end of the video as well.
So my question's for Rio. So you were named in the J-League Team of the Year alongside your teammate, Dyson Minor. How much confidence do you take from this, and do you see yourself as an ambassador the Japanese game, thanks to achievements like this?
僕自身そういう賞を取れたことはすごく嬉しいですし、自信にもつながると思いますけど、こっちに来たらそういうのは関係なくなってくると思うんで、また新たにこのチームで自分らしくプレーしたいなと思います。
I knew for a fact you were going to ask Rio a question, Ryan, because it seems to be the guy you've taken a liking to the most. You asked about his Team of the Year appearance. And pretty sort of adamant that, you know, that's in the past. Now he's here at Celtic and he's focusing on his new start. Are you excited to see Rio Hatate come into this Celtic side?
Yeah, very much so. I mean, I seen a tweet today that he was playing in a bounce game with Ediguchi and Maeda. He was playing in the midfield. I think it was against St Mirren. Don't quote me on that, but I heard it was St Mirren. So it's good that they're getting some game time in their legs, and obviously they'll be ready. But I was really impressed by Hatate's answer. I like that he nodded to his Team of the Year appearance, but at the same time, it's like a clean slate. It's the same for Ediguchi. Ediguchi wasn't in the Team of the Year. He had a bit of a mixed experience at Osaka, but it's a clean slate. It's a clean slate for Hatate for a different reason, which is great. They're all coming in the same sort of stage in their career. They're all the same sort of age, which is absolutely brilliant. And we'll see how they get on. But I was really impressed by his answer.
There was a lot of, obviously, questions when he came in and when he was signed about how he would be used at Celtic, and it was clarified when he did sign. I think the manager clarified that as well, but he also further went into that yesterday, talking about how he'll be used in the midfield. Ryan, are you happy about that?
Yeah, because it's his best position. I don't want to be putting players into positions that they don't really want to be playing. I want players playing in their best position. It's clear the way he plays. He's an all-action midfielder. So I think he'll slot in really, really nicely in this team. Going back to the press conference, I was a bit worried that nobody was going to ask you the Gucci a question, but because the two players.
It seemed like Maeda was a very popular man at the start. He got like three.
You knew that was going to be the case.
Yep.
I kind of put away my questions for Maeda early on because I was one of the later ones to ask a question. And by that time, Ediguchi did have a couple of questions posed to him, which was absolutely brilliant. But Maeda was really, really popular. But you get that with attackers. Attackers get the questions. They're the ones that get the headlines at the end of the day. So I wasn't really surprised. But the three of them came across really well, and I'm looking forward to seeing how they do.
Yeah, I'm excited because, once again, we've said this many, many times, and I'm sure we'll talk about this all sorts in the podcast for the remainder of this season. There are three guys coming in that we really know very little about. We don't even know quite to an extent how much they're going to be relied upon in terms of first-team football. Will they be options purely for depth? Will there be first-team options? We've got to find out the quality of players ultimately they're dealing with there. We could be finding the next big thing, or they could be, simply depth options. There's so much that goes around it, but I was really happy to hear from all of them, and you know, obviously there is that struggle of the language barrier, but you get there in the end, and you get some really fascinating answers from some of them, and I like that they are determined to come here and do well, and a lot of questions have been asked about this point in their career and why it's the right time to sort of come to Celtic. We'll kind of move on to Maeda a little bit, Ryan. From yesterday, what do you remember? What kind of stood out from him?
I think it's his confidence. This guy's really, really headstrong, and he really wants to do well at Celtic. I thought out of the three of them, he was the most confident in his answers. I noticed Gucci had to sort of do a double take every couple of questions.
You're marking a solo talks in English.
I know. That was a couple of years ago. I'd done my solo talk. I was never good at them. I think out of the three of them, Maeda was the most confident out of the three, which I mean as an attacker, you want that confidence to come through. He was talking well about the fans. He said he was delighted to hear that 60,000 are going to be there on Monday. I'm glad that he's kind of clued in with all that kind of stuff. I'm really, really excited to see him. I think he will be one of the players that will start on Monday, just due to the fact that Jota's still coming back from his injury. I think he'll be another couple of games, or we'll be trying to phase him into the team. But I think Maida's ready to go, and that's absolutely brilliant for us. I think we'll see him on the left-hand side on Monday night.
Yeah, I'm looking forward. I mean, we've seen that clip yesterday in Celtic's social media, as how fast he looks, Ryan. He looks absolutely rapid.
He is absolutely rapid.
He's terrorised this league.
Mm-hmm. I got a lot of stick for some reason. I don't know. It seems to be recently that a lot of Rangers fans have found my profile. I'd just like to say welcome to them, first of all. Please leave a follow if you can. But I just said, what was it? Eight out of the top 10, or seven out of the top 10 for sprints per game were Maida. Those are really good stats. Now, I know speed isn't everything in the game, but in this league, you can make quite a career if you're really quick. So if he's finishing anywhere near as good as his speed, then he's going to cause a lot of trouble in this league. If he's anything like Kyogo, and you've seen how well Kyogo's done, then I think he'll be a problem in this league.
Yeah, of course. I've seen a lot of people look at that graphic and those statistics and go, and, you know, they make those same jokes every time where it's like, you know, expected sneezes per game, and they try and compare out. This is the modern game, you know. We do see statistics driving a large part of what we do. But I think it's more out of fear. They know that this guy's got to come in, and he's got to come in and terrorise defenders. It might not necessarily be Rangers defenders, but that guy's going to make a difference, I think, over the long term that he's in this league. There's defenders that have struggled to put up with Kyogo since he's came in. Think about it, if they've got two players like that, you know, that is a real danger, and people do have a fear of that sort of player.
Yeah, you look at the strength and depth that we've now got in the sort of wide areas, especially if we get James Forrest coming back. Now, I'm not saying he'll be the same player when he comes back. These injuries take a toll. But if he can still contribute with assists and goals, you've got Abada, you've got Dembele that's back in training, you've got now Maida, you've got Jota coming back. I mean, look at all the options that we've got at our disposal. And that's the thing. If they're terrorising defences, then they'll probably get a double team on them. They'll get two men man marking them. So that means that somebody else will be free, whether that be a striker or another winger or the attacking midfielder. You could see Hatate coming in for goals as well this season, which is absolutely brilliant. All of a sudden, you're now seeing goals all over the park, which is only going to help the team in the long run. I'm just really, really excited. It seems as if these players are now proper Ange players. These players can play the football that Ange wants to play, and they'll be ready. I just hope that they can get settled and acclimatised. That was another interesting thing. Maida says that he's still getting used to the sort of the way of eating over here, which is absolutely fine. You expect that. You just hope that he settles quickly and he can be comfortable in his new surroundings.
Yep, that's what I hope for all three of them. Listen, it's going to be a longer video. We're going to play a little bit of the clip now, but that'll probably do it for the conversation. Ryan, I thank you once more for coming on for the channel today. We'll be back with a podcast return this week at some point. Not quite certain on which day it will be yet. I don't know exactly who's going to be there yet. Ryan might be there. I'm not sure. We'll have it sorted.
Probably will be.
We'll have it all sorted, and the Celtic Thunder will be back. I'm buzzing for the return right before our game against Hibs on Monday night. But from us just now, we'll play you out with some of the press conference from yesterday. Like and subscribe, and we'll see you all next time. Cheerio.
Guys, one quote I read from you was, your strength is your speed. Does it bring more strength working with a manager who you're familiar with and also three fellow Japanese players?
Speed はやっぱりチームの助けになると思うので、スピードを生かしてやっぱり守備やったり攻撃の部分で助けれればいいと思って、まあ、日本人、まあ、4人で一緒に試合に出てチームの勝利に貢献できるのがやっぱりベストだと思うので頑張りたいかなというふうに思います。
This is looking for Daizan as well. What type of player are you? What can the fans expect from yourself?
まあやっぱりゴールはやっぱり期待されると思うので、まあ、ゴールの部分やったり本当にがむしゃらに戦っている姿を見せたいかなっていうふうに思います。
I believe one thing you can expect from me is hopefully goals, but also also my attitude is, you know, pure fight, you know, fight attitude. So I would love everyone to expect that from me.
Rio, we've watched a lot of you here from the Cine Club, as we, like most Celtic fans, might get to know what type of player you are. Can you let us know what the manager expects of you and what your best attributes are you think will fit into the philosophy that Ange Postecoglou is brought to Celtic?
まだ監督と話してないんでそこら辺はよくわかんないですけど、でも攻撃的なポジションでこう欲しい、攻撃的なポジションで使いたいとは言ってたんで、まず攻撃の部分のゴールだったりっていう部分は求められていると思いますし、まあ、ファンとサポーターには自分のプレーはゴールに向かうところが一番の持ち味だと思うので、そこは見てほしいなと思います。
I haven't had a chance yet to talk a lot with the manager, but he is expecting me to be more in an attacking position as well. So I hope what the fans can expect from me is that position towards the goal and do well there.